Okay, this is going to be integrating in spherical coordinates, and my name is Jody DeVoe. Okay, so let's take a look at our first example. Fairly straightforward. It's just kind of to try to give us some warm, fuzzy feelings, I guess, about integrating in spherical coordinates. What I'd like to do is I'd like to use spherical coordinates to find the volume of a sphere of radius r. Okay, so we want to find the volume of a sphere of radius r. Now, I'm not saying that we would ever use spherical coordinates to find this volume. What I'd like to do is set up the spherical coordinates integral to actually calculate this and compare our answer that we get using triple integration in spherical coordinates with the geometric formula we're already familiar with. So we all remember what the volume of a sphere of radius r is. It is volume equals 4/3 pi r cubed. So hopefully what will happen is we'll set up this triple integral in spherical coordinates. We'll integrate it, and we should come up with the same answer in either case. Okay, so let's take a look. First thing we need to know is that the dv element for spherical coordinates is rho squared sine phi, and then d rho, d phi, d theta in any order you wish. Now, if you're wondering where that comes from, I'm not going to derive it here. If you're interested, you can take a look at another one of the pencasts to see where that comes from. But we need to have this dv element whenever we integrate in spherical coordinates. So we'll start off with our three integral signs. We're looking for a volume. So I'm just going to integrate 1 here to get a volume, and then I'll need this dv element in here. So that's the rho squared sine phi, and then d rho, d phi, d theta. Okay, so again, this is my dv element, my volume element, and I'm just going to integrate that then over this region r, which in our case, r is going to be our sphere. So r is the whole sphere. Okay, so I'm assuming that you've already watched the other two pencasts. Actually, I guess those were Jing videos that I've done on understanding what rho, phi, and theta are. So I'm assuming you're coming into this pencast with that knowledge already in place. Okay, so rho is, again, the distance measured from the origin out to a point. So on our sphere, the distance from the origin out to the surface of the sphere, that would be the radius of the sphere, r. So I want to start with rho at 0, that is at the center, and then make this extend out to the shell of the sphere, which is a distance of r, the radius of the sphere. Okay, then with phi and theta, I want to cover the whole sphere, okay, all of it. So to cover the whole sphere, I want to let phi start up there at the positive z-axis, so I'm going to let phi start at 0. I want to go all the way down to its full extent to the negative z-axis, so I'm going to go from 0 to pi. So the picture I have right now then is maybe something that looks like this. Let's see, this is x and y, and here's z, and what I have pictured in my mind, I guess, is kind of a half of a circle. Okay, so this distance out here is that r, and so far I've let the angle phi start up here on the positive z-axis, and then it's going all the way down here around to the negative z-axis. So I've got this half of a circle, and then to get the whole sphere, I want to rotate that half circle all the way around the z-axis. Okay, and if I take that half circle, rotate it around the z-axis, that should get me that ball or that sphere. So to rotate it around all the way around, I need to have theta go from 0 to 2 pi. Okay, so that should give me the whole ball. Now, if you want to just pause for a second here and think about, well, how is it that I get maybe like the top half of the ball? The top half of the ball, what would change? Well, to get the top half of the ball, that means that I still want to go all the way around in the theta direction from 0 to 2 pi, but the only thing then would change would be the angle phi. To get the top half of a ball, I don't want anything below the xy plane, so I would cut my phi angle to go from 0 to pi over 2. That would give me the top half. To get the bottom half, I would let phi start at pi over 2 and go all the way down to pi. So just to kind of give you a couple of ideas of visualizations on that ball idea. Okay, now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and integrate this. And when I integrate this, again, we're hoping that it's going to come up to be the volume of a sphere that we know from geometry. Okay, so I'm going to start on the inside part here. I'm going to integrate first with respect to rho. So I have 0 to 2 pi, 0 to pi. I'm going to integrate the first time. I'm going to have rho cubed. I'm going to put my 1/3 on the outside of the whole integration. That way I don't have to drag that fraction and mess with it all the way through the whole process. Let's see, this will have to be evaluated from 0 to r, and then I still have my sine phi. I've integrated with respect to rho, so that's gone, but I still have the d phi and the d theta. Okay, now when I put the r in for the rho, that would result in r cubed and 0 at the lower limit, so that's 1/3, 0 to 2 pi, 0 to pi. Substituting r in, I get r cubed, and at the lower limit, 0, and then sine phi, d phi, d theta. Okay, so the only thing that survives out of there is that r cubed. And again, I'm going to pull it outside of the whole integral so I don't have to mess with it again. Just kind of drag it along. Okay, now I'm ready to integrate with respect to phi. So if I integrate sine phi, I get negative cosine phi. I'm going to pull that negative sign out in front of everything. Don't have to mess with it that way. My 0 to 2 pi is still there. Integrating sine gives me negative cosine phi. Evaluated between 0 and pi, I've integrated with respect to phi, so my d theta is still there. Okay, then I'm going to put my pi in and my 0 in for phi. So that's negative r cubed over 3, 0 to 2 pi, cosine of pi, minus cosine of 0, and then all of this will need to be finally integrated with respect to theta. I'm going to put some brackets around there, I think. Okay, so cosine phi, well, let's see, cosine of pi, I'm going to think back to my little graph for cosine. Cosine is the one that looks like this. So that's 2 pi, and that's pi. So the cosine of pi is negative 1. So let's go ahead and put that in there, I guess. Negative r cubed over 3, 0 to 2 pi. First one I'm going to get here is negative 1. The cosine of 0 is 1. Let's be careful there. That's not 0. That's negative 1 minus 1. That's negative 2. So I'm going to pull that negative 2 out in front of everything. The negative 2 in front of everything will flip that sign back to positive 2. So I have 2/3 then on the outside, r cubed, and then 0 to 2 pi, d theta. Okay, when I integrate d theta, I just get theta. So I have 2/3 r cubed. And then integrating, I get just theta, and theta will need to be evaluated between 0 and 2 pi. Okay, I'm almost done. I've got 2/3 r cubed. When I put my 2 pi in there, it's going to get 2 pi minus 0, or just the 2 pi, and there it is. That's 2 pi times the 2/3 that's already there. That makes 4 pi over 3 r cubed for my volume, and that's exactly what we know the volume of a sphere to be. Okay, so we get the same answer that the geometry tells us we should. That hopefully makes you feel pretty good about spherical coordinates. I hope this helped. Thanks.